Let's look at how general ledger and cost elements are set up in SAP Simple Finance. Before, GL accounts were maintained in the SKA1, SKB1 and SKAT tables. You create the GL accounts using the FS00 transaction. First you create the GL accounts, then you go and proceed to create the cost elements if it's a P&L GL account. Cost elements are maintained in the CSKA, CSKB and CSKU tables. So cost element creation, you use the transaction code KA01, KA02 for change, KA03 for display. Sometimes in the GL account master data itself, you have the option of edit cost element button where you go and create your cost element. Things are changed now in Simple Finance. Let's see that in the next slide. Now in Simple Finance, the GL accounts are still maintained in the same SKA1, SKB1, so and so tables. The cost elements are still maintained in the CSKA, CSKB and CSKU tables. However, you do not create cost elements using the transaction code KA01 or KA02 and so on. These cost elements will be created using FS00, that is creation of GL accounts, which means you do not create cost elements, you only create GL accounts. All cost elements are now going to be GL accounts in Simple Finance. So in the GL master data table, there is a field called GL account underscore type, which will automatically update the cost element tables. We'll see this in more detail in our next slide. In the GL master data create transaction, at the time of creating your GL account, if it's going to be an expense or a revenue item, you need to select what option it is in the account type field. This is in the first screen or first tab, which is your type slash description tab. Under that, under the control in chart of account section, you have this field called account type, which the field name is GL account underscore type. Here you need to select whether it's going to be a primary cost or revenue element or a secondary cost element. If it's a balance sheet account, then of course it's not going to be created as a cost element. So you can just straight away select as a balance sheet account. This screen is different from what you're used to seeing in the old ERP system. So if it's going to be a primary cost element, you select this option. And if it's going to be a secondary cost element, you select the next option. This is what defines whether this GL account is going to be created as a cost element or not. In the next tab of the GL master data section, the control tab, the next two subsections are the same. However, you get a third category called account settings in controlling area, whatever controlling area you have mentioned to create this GL account under. And here you need to define the cost element category. So usually you maintain 1 if it's a primary cost and 11 if it's going to be a revenue cost element. This is where you maintain the cost element category. This is also a different section which was not used to be there before. So how about the assets which are created as cost element category 90? Well, in the first tab of the GL account master data, you select the balance sheet account. And then as per the account group, you select your fixed assets account. This is pretty much the same as you used to do before. But in the next tab under control data, there is another section which you need to tick, which says apply account assignments statistically in fixed asset accounting. This will create this particular GL account, the balance sheet account, with cost element category 90. A mandatory selection is that you must make sure that asset account is selected as a reconciliation account. Let's look at the impact on period locks. So in Simple Finance, the CO period lock OKP1 has to align with the GL opening and closing of periods using transaction code OB52. Because now the cost elements are also GL accounts. Which means if you have blocked some GL accounts and if they are part of the cost elements, then you cannot do any CO postings within those cost elements. So if there are any secondary cost elements, you must make sure they are unblocked. Then only you can do your allocation cycles or any other manual repostings between two cost centers or any other cost objects. because now cost elements are also GL accounts. The GL accounts which are also created as secondary cost elements has to be open for do any transactions. So when you do period and closing, ensure that you only close the financial accounting relevant GL accounts, and any other management accounting secondary cost elements should not be locked. Otherwise, you'll not be able to do any of the CO related transactions like the allocation cycles. Let's quickly recap of what we discussed. Cost elements are now GL accounts. So you don't create cost elements using the KA01, KA06 transactions, where there's going to be a primary cost element or secondary cost element, you're going to create them as GL accounts. Now remember, because the secondary cost elements are also GL accounts, you should not block these secondary cost elements in your open-close transactions. That means for period and closing, make sure they are still available to post in those periods if you want to do any CO allocations or CO cycles.